here we go. Here is Nectaris, Heart 10. This is Darwin. You can see this is not exactly a simple map. We have five, count on five, neutral depots. It's not going to be easy or short. Let's go. So for once, I have a unit advantage to start out. But before we get too excited, let's see exactly what that advantage consists of. We have a Charlie. We have two Hawkeyes, which are bad, I guess. We have, well, the typical composition of a Falcon and an Eagle. Hadrian, Seeker. Should we have a good anti-air force going on? And we have really a wealth of depots to choose from. Of course, we also have our own depot, which contains still more planes, a grizzly, and a panther. I don't really know what we would want to put in the mule, considering, the panther is faster than the mule. I guess it would be the other Charlie. Again, in a big map like this, really our top priority is taking these depots, so we're actually going to hold off on the Air Force, because, well, Grizzly needs time to do anything. Now, out of these, first, before we decide on depots, let's take a look at the enemy. Of course, he has his own Hunter, an Octopus, two infantry of his own, one on a bike. And if we look, he has another Hunter, another Panther. So, let's start with the top. Ooh, this is a good depot. We have a Hunter, Adrian, Octopus. Not bad at all. I really want to get my own Hunter at some point. This is, we have an Atlas and a Pelican. That's pretty much the highlight of this depot. In the middle, we have still another Hunter. And a Pelican with a Charlie just ready and waiting to hop in. And here is, that's not too much, really. Down on the bottom, we have, it's good. No Hunter, but not bad. So I think what we want to do first is go for the top right depot. So we're going to send our bike this way. Let's see. I want to get in the range of either Hunter. So actually this Eagle is as far forward as we can safely move. So Eagle's going to come here. Now on the other hand, I want to protect the Panther. So I'm going to move this Hawkeye out. Follow him with the Falcon. Here. Again, check the safe range. Okay, we can't move any further than these two planes. So we're going to move him here. Move the Hadrian up as well. Move the Seeker up. Forward. What do we do with the Hawkeye? Do we go around? And the Hawkeyes? Hawkeyes are still. Hawkeyes can move over here, but I'm going to just put it here. And that's turn one. Let's see. I'm very curious what the AI strike. He is also going for the top right depot. Not really surprising, really. Hunters come out guns blazing. Not surprising. Everyone else is moving a little slower. Not too worried about that run up there. Well, his Charlie is a lot further from the action. His depot is a lot closer to the action. So now three Hunters. And another Panther. Okay. Gotta do some thinking here. So we have an issue here, which is that this Panther can make it to this depot, which is okay, but not where I really want to go, which is this depot. And if I make any wrong move, then both of these two Hunters are going to make me pay for it. What I can do, though, is go after the two Hunters. The problem is, if I want to prevent the Panther from getting the depot, I need something to block it. So that's trouble. I think I have a solution. Yeah. Okay, I can do this. So I'm going to put this eagle in a highly suicidal position. I'm actually going to attack the hunter, because I need to do as much damage as possible. It's a very bad move. Don't do this, please. Well, it was completely pointless, doing nothing other than doing 2 starts for the hunter. But it did get a surround. And I got no point for it. That is just fantastic. I actually lost in that exchange. So what I'm going to do now is park this here. And move my panther just 2 steps away. Okay, it's going to come along. Well, I still have this, so... Oh my god, awful! Really? Truly terrible. These guys are gonna come down here. Okay, one more shot. I really want this hunter gone. There, got it. Finally the 2.5. Really. Just gotta do it that way, huh? Well, it was a true team effort. Hawkeye rumbles forward. Here comes Grizzly. Okay, where do I want to go? This depot is okay. These two are good. So I'm going to come down here. I'm going to send both of my remaining infantry down this way. And unload the rest of my air force. So I'm gonna need it against those 3 hunters. What do you got now? Ooh, you gotta take the long way around. That was a bit weird. Ooh, he's going after the other panther. Surprising. Ooh, missed it by that much. What a pity. Well, poor Eagle. He did his job. Oh, an 0.4. He might be able to continue doing his job. That's a real shame. Ooh, yeah. AI really needed this turn to go a little better. Yeah, he's just realizing that things are going a little iffy for him. So I have captured a top right depot. So these hunters are in a bit of trouble. Things on a map that are as big as this happen quite quickly. Okay, not a bad start. Falcon, can he get to the depot? Of course he can. Falcon 1 gets here now. What's important is, can't let Panther get to the depot, because then not only will he get everything, he'll get my Panther. Speaking of Panther, should he retreat? Nah, no retreat. So what I'm going to do first, do I want the eagle to go away now, or am I willing to sacrifice the eagle? Yeah, I'm willing to sacrifice the eagle. Let's get us around, don't fire. And the hunter has walked straight into a trap. Ugh, come on. Again, the rabbit is going to have to clean things up with its 10 air attack. And some help. A lot of help. Splash another hunter. Oop. Surround, just the way I like it. Okay, unfortunately I don't have much left here. But it hardly hurts. It's a good start. And this is going to be a good finish. that is how you destroy hunters. Okay. So now, Panther is free to, well, hold on. Panthers can't cross rocks. Remember that. Oh no, they can cross rocks. It just takes three spaces. Oh no. So yeah, these are rock spaces. Cannot be crossed by panthers. That's annoying. So instead, well, that was silly. City's gonna go down here. This mule is gonna come down here, and I'm all done. This eagle is toast, but I don't really care. Man. This air force is already dead, wow. Okay. So we really need to protect this depot. Sort of an issue is we don't have too many direct fire units to do it. So we're gonna take this panther to cut off his infantry. And unload that panther. We got a Hadrian. We got an octopus. Should've done that in reverse order. The octopus's range is bad. We got a pelican. Which we will load with panther next turn. We got a rabbit. And we got a useless hawkeye. And we got this eagle, which sort of comes over here. No, I don't want to get in range of his secret. What's his secret's range? Okay, you can't get past my secret. So we come over here, and we rumble the grizzly up, and this guy is going to be sort of patiently waiting. Actually, I'm going to move him up here, because those rocks are going to take forever to get through. And just like that, on turn three, things are going very badly for our enemy. Things are also going very badly for my eagle. Oh, wow. Wow, that just adds insult to injury right there. Yeah, things now going very badly indeed. That deep. Oh, hold on. Can't be letting that go. Yeah, so this is gonna go, this is just unfortunate that my eagle survived the way it did. But this super is not long for this world. Of course, I could have just moved the other eagle in place and then here. Okay, almost forgot. Remember, fire with indirects first. Be like me, and needlessly toss units away. Almost there. Oh, I can make it. Fantastic. 31 units. Isn't that great? Of course you can only unload two of them at a time. But oh. This is just rubbing it in. Okay, Charlie. Well, he's almost there. Rabbit's gonna come in. There we go. Goodbye. It's amazing how quickly things can change in a map. And something that looked difficult becomes easy. Just like that. And his only hope is about to go up in smoke. Well, hopefully. Really? That's the best you could do? Well, he's not going anywhere now. Oh, he's so close. You can almost feel it. No, not anymore. And things were looking so even just, a turn ago. Now this is just not fair. Attack from two sides. Sounds like fun. How about sticking my hunter on his only remaining entire hand? That sounds like lots of fun. Having a hunter, in general, is lots of fun. Especially because this game really conspires against you to try to prevent it. It's not really meant for you to, it's not really meant for you to get the hunter in this scenario. Fortunately, the panther's already moved, so it'll be two more turns before I can capture the flag. But it won't be too much fun. Let's see, man, this grizzly missed out on all the fun. I'm just hot, I got a shot off for the Amazon star. This is just slaughter. Turn four. Look at it. How did everything go so wrong? Man, this almost makes me want to like see how this stage is when you do it properly, right? You know, when you don't make a beeline for the top right depot and instead you let the enemy get it, you go for the bottom depot, you slog it out over the middle depots. I mean, of course, it's good strategy, you know, block the enemy panther off with your planes and get your own there first. And the enemy could do it. I mean, that's pretty advanced for an AI to figure out, you know. Well, it's not going to last too much longer. Let's see, will I be able to destroy everyone on this turn? Let's see. I have a lot of troops. Adrian, Slagger. The Lenin practically blows up on its own. I like this sort of random factor, you know, where they don't all fire at the same time. Not exactly a clash of the titans here. Ooh, maximum carnage. Just the way I like it. Let's position myself on the rocks. Ooh, the octopus. Almost forgot about him. So many units, I barely know what to do with them. I just like octopuses because of the animation. I mean, they each fire twice. That's pretty cool. This is hardly necessary. I win on the next turn no matter what, but, you know, it's fine. Good practice for future scenarios that are actually difficult too. Look at that, this is the point where a rabbit retreats and is able to take its full star to be truly meaningful. So we're gonna get the full surround. We're going to make the panther nice and toasty. It never know what hit it. Ooh, that's too bad. Man, most of these guys never even got in the fight. Do another depot. Sure, why not? Yeah, so the problem with this depot is you only get one on load point. Might as well attack from two fronts here. Oh no, I want the other depot. I want a clean sweep. Man, more units. Well, again, 35 units is not exactly going to be a lot when we come to some of the later scenarios here. I like, they're like, eh, can I get on the HQ? Wait, no, I can't actually get on the HQ. That sort of sucks. 39 units. And another hunter. I like hunters when they're on my side. Okay, I think that's more than enough of that. I honestly don't get what the results are supposed to be. I thought there were losses, but I mean, like, what losses did I take on turn 2? And they certainly weren't as big as the enemy's losses on turns 4 and 5. I mean, that's, you know, destroying their entire army. But, well, whatever. That was stage 10. I hope that strategy helps. I'm sure the scenario is a lot more difficult if you don't do that. So see you next week for stage 11 Pascal. Hope you enjoyed. Please leave a comment. I really appreciate knowing that someone is actually watching. Because, well, I don't believe anyone is. But if you are, please do. I'm lonely. See you next time. Oh, here's a little preview Pascal. Well, it's big, and of course, the grays are near the greens. But I'm sure I'll find out some way to deal with it.